Welcome to today's Badou Jack versus Jane Degale media conference call. Today we're going to hear from the main event participants who will be headlining next week's main event at Barclays in Brooklyn. Our event will be live on Showtime, and our event is promoted by Mayweather Promotions and Develop Entertainment. Badou Jack, WBC Super Middleweight Champion, will be taking on the IBF Super Middleweight Champion, James Degale, in a meeting in a world title unification that pits the best versus the best. We're very excited about our great event. These two fighters have been on a collision course ever since they won their world title. They both made successful world title defenses last April, and with the intention of this big, big moment come next Saturday, January the 14th. The Showtime Championship boxing doubleheader begins at 9:30 p.m. Eastern Time, 6:30 p.m. Pacific Time, and our show will open with IBF Junior Lightweight World Champion Jose Pedraza, who will be battling Mayweather Promotions' own rising star, Gervonta Davis. In addition, there will be action on Showtime and stream starting at 7 p.m. Eastern Time, Pacific Time, and it will be headlined by four division world champion Amanda Serrano, which will be a very, very exciting fight. She'll be defending her junior featherweight title against two division champion Yasmin Rivas, who will be the first nationally televised female world title fight in nearly a decade. First, I'd like to introduce my dear friend and promotional partner, Lou Davella, president of Davella Entertainment.
Thank you, Leonard. And it's been a real pleasure working with you, Leonard, and Floyd and your team. I've been very impressed by the professionalism, and you guys have been great to work with. And it'll be great to welcome you guys to your first major promotion in New York next week, so I look forward to seeing you here. As Leonard pointed out, this is a terrific card from beginning to end, and that begins even with the off-TV undercard, which will feature undefeated Polish-American heavyweight Adam Kownacki against a top opponent in one of the toughest fights of his career so far. Prospect Julian Sosa, who's an undefeated prospect from New York City, former Golden Glove champion and a huge ticket seller in New York. Noel Murphy, another local fighter from Ireland, and Kenny Robles, who was recently signed by Mayweather Promotions from Staten Island, New York. And those guys will headline the off-TV undercard. Leonard mentioned the main event, Amanda Serrano, who I promote, one of the best pound-for-pound women fighters in the world, against Yasmin Rivas. That's a tremendous fight, and I thank Steven Espinoza for giving the ladies that kind of an opportunity and showcase. The Showtime Extreme card will also feature a co-featured bout between number two middleweight contender in the WBC, Yevgeny Hitrov, versus Emmanuel Aleem, another undefeated middleweight prospect. That bout will be for the WBC silver middleweight title, and the winner will be on course for an eventual shot at the WBC middleweight championship. So the undercard is terrific, and the main event really doesn't need a lot of hype. It's as good as it gets. It's the best versus the best. It doesn't really get any better than that. I was lucky enough to promote early in his career Badou Jack, who's a terrific, terrific fighter, who's improved and proven himself in every test he's faced. James Degale, former Olympic gold medalist, on a 13-fight winning streak, one of the most talented and also one of the most interesting and charismatic fighters in all of boxing and in the 68-pound division. So we have a great main event for Showtime to start the year. And I'll throw it back to Leonard to introduce the man who put this fight together with us, Steven Espinoza. Leonard?
Okay. Thank you, Luke, for those great comments. Just like Lou just mentioned, we owe a great deal of thanks to Steven Espinoza, who worked tirelessly with our team and Lou's team to put this great event together. He's a very dear friend. And like I said, we are really, really excited, again, to be working with Showtime. It gets no better than that. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce none other than Stephen Espinosa.
Thanks, Leonard. In 2016, Showtime consistently telecast the best, most competitive, most important fights in the sport. More fights than any other network, more title fights than any other network, more top 10 versus top 10 fights than any other network. And together with our promoter partners, we're going to continue doing exactly that in 2017. Jack versus Degale is the first of three number one versus number two matchups that are on the Showtime schedule, and that's just the first quarter. That's a highly anticipated fight, a fight that we've been working toward for a year, so we're pleased to be kicking off the new year with the consensus two best fighters in the division. As Lou mentioned, the main event is supported by an intriguing lightweight title fight between champion Jose Pedraza and Mayweather Promotions' highly touted prospect, Gervonta Tank Davis. Plus, on Showtime Extreme, we've had the women's title fight featuring Amanda Serrano, who it's no exaggeration to say is, in fact, one of the top pound-for-pound fighters in the world. If you haven't seen her fight, you should definitely tune in for this one. And we've got a battle of undefeated prospects, Evgen Kitrov and Emmanuel Lim. So really, it is a stellar card, top to bottom, four intriguing televised fights, a bunch of high-quality off-TV fights, plus, of course, the main event, a world title unification fight. Once again, demonstrating Showtime Championship Boxing is the destination for the best fights in the sport. Showtime's where the best fight the best, champion versus champion, all on Showtime, no pay-per-views. No other network is as committed to this sport, and together with Mayweather Promotions and Develop Entertainment, we are all committed to growing the sport and pushing this sport forward. Leonard?
Thank you. Can you hear me?
Yes, we got you, Leonard.
Yep. Oh, okay. All right. So are we ready to introduce James?
Yes, but just quickly before I do that, I also want to point out that this, you know, this fight, we've gotten a lot of help and assistance from one of the great venues in boxing, the great destinations for boxing in the country right now. Brett Yormark and all the people at Barclays Center in Brooklyn, we thank them for their help in promoting this great event and hosting it. You're going to see a lot of great boxing, a lot of great Showtime boxing also at the Barclays Center this year. And thank Brett to everyone at the Barclays Center. Tickets are available at Ticketmaster.com through the Barclays Center box office. The tickets are priced incredibly reasonably with ringside, you know, VIP ringside seats at $300 going down to I think it's a $40 low price. And there are, you know, while we're selling really well, there are plenty of good seats available. So we urge people to begin the year with this great card and get your tickets as soon as you can. The ringside and the prime locations are moving very quickly. And without further ado, it's my pleasure to introduce a fighter that I have tremendous respect for. I was lucky enough to promote his victory against Andre Durrell for the IBF belt in Boston in May of 2015. He's made two more defenses of that belt over Lucien Boutte and Rogelio Medina. Again, he was riding a 13-fight winning streak. And definitely one of the two best 68-pounders in the world. And this event's going to determine who the man really is. So it's my pleasure to introduce James Chunky Degale.
Hello. Hello, everyone. The big one's here. The best fight in the best, champ versus champ. This is the one that I've been calling for. I've been on the case to my advisor, Al Heyman, to say that's the one I want. I think this fight determines who is the number one in the division. I think Badou Jack's a hell of a fighter, a real good fighter, underrated fighter. He's shown his last three, four fights that he's the champ and that he can compete at the highest level and he's a quality operator. Camp's gone fantastically well. I'm feeling good, sharp, my weight, I'm in fantastic shape. Just go and look on my Instagram, I'm in fantastic shape. Been in camp for 10 weeks, feeling great mentally and physically, in fantastic position. As I say, on the 14th of January, you lot are in for a treat, because it's going to be a hell of a fight. There's a lot on the line, so enjoy it, but it should be a good one.
Thank you, James, for those comments. Next up, I'd like to introduce Mayweather Promotions own, the WBC super middleweight champion. He's originally from Stockholm, Sweden, but he trains in Las Vegas. He won his world title in 2015 by defeating Anthony Durrell in a very, very exciting fight. Later that year, he faced top challenger George Groves, the only man to beat James Degale in the pros. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce none other than Badou. Jack.
Hey, what's up? How's everybody doing? We finally here. We got another week, and then it's on. The best versus the best. And I'm very excited. I've been training really hard. I can't wait to fight night. Thank you.
Good. Okay, well, thank you, Badou, for your comments. So we would like to open up the line for questions.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you have any questions at this time, please press star 1 on your telephone keypad. Again, if you have any questions at this time, please press star 1 on your telephone keypad. And I'm waiting for callers to join the queue at this present time. Well, our first question is going to come from Dan Raphael from ESPN. Please go ahead.
Hello, everybody. My first question is for James. James, how are you today?
All good, Dan. All good.
Here's my question for you, James. Like Lou mentioned, you won your world title in Boston against Andre Durrell, and your other fights in world championship fights were in Canada and in the United States. And obviously, you know, you're an Olympic gold medalist from England. I'm wondering, what is it about you that makes you the road warrior that you've become, basically fighting all of your biggest fights so far in your career have been away from the U.K., which has become a very big deal as far as boxing, so many world champions and so many top fights, but you're a guy that's been going on the road. Why is that?
I don't know why it is, but I actually like boxing away from home. It takes the pressure off you a little bit. And listen, I'm living the American dream. Do you know what I'm saying? I'm coming over to America, boxing these fantastic states, and getting the fantastic opportunities from Al Heyman, but this one is the big one. New York, the Barclays Center, unifying the division, so you can't beat it.
James, do you have a desire that after this fight, you know, assuming you, let's say you win the fight, you're a unified world champion, do you have a desire to actually go back home to England and have a world title defense?
That's
or would
the
you
plan.
Like to continue
that's
boxing over here?
No, that's the plan, to go home. To go back home. Touch wood, everything goes to plan. I beat Badou Jack next May. I'm going home. I'm going home, and I'm having a big fight at home. Everyone's calling for the champ to come home. So, yeah, that's next on the line. Everything goes to plan.
Okay, very good. I have a question for Badou. Badou, how are you today?
I'm great, Dan. How you doing?
I'm doing great. I wanted to get your opinion about the fact that James has been willing to fight on the road, that he was able to go into Boston and come to America and beat Durrell for that title, and also to continue defending the title both in Butte's home area, then again on the card that you guys both fought on together. I mean, I know you want to beat him up come next week, but I would imagine the fact that he went on the road like that, you have to have some respect for that. Can you talk about just his ability and how he's fought on the road over the last few fights? Not a normal thing for top fighters to do.
Yeah, you got to give him credit for that. You know, he come to people's backyard, you know, and win. So, yeah, absolutely. But also, I think they lost the purse business. He was forced to go to Boston. But you know, he's a good fighter, and I have nothing but respect for him. But come fight night, we're gonna go to war.
Let's not forget who I beat for the world title as well. I boxed Andre Durrell in America. This Andre Durrell comes from good pedigree, a good quality technical fighter. Like, this belt wasn't handed to me. You know what I mean? I've done it the hard way. All of my career, I've done it the hard way. Traveled away from home, won world titles. Hear me? So.
Hey, do you guys, you both fought together on that same show in Washington in April in defending your titles. And I know that that the idea was to hopefully have this fight between you guys have had taken place at the end of 2016. Obviously, that did not work out for a variety of reasons. But I'm wondering, are you at all a little bit disappointed that it didn't get done before the fight next week? Or are you okay with the fact that you guys are both on equal footing and coming off of the nine-month layoff? James, could you answer that?
If I'm being honest, the only reason why this fight hasn't happened quicker is because Badou Jack didn't want it. After the Boutte fight, he probably didn't want it. And then after the Medina fight, because I boxed rubbish, because Medina went 12 rounds of me, Badou Jack's got a lot of confidence. His team, Leonard's got a lot of confidence. Mayweather's got a lot of confidence of him seeing me go 12 rounds, yeah? And it was a lackluster performance against Medina. But you shouldn't take too much away from that. That's what I'm trying to say. Don't take too much away from me fighting Medina and performing like that.
Hey, Badou, would you like to have had this fight at the end of the year?
That's the only reason why this fight's getting made.
That's all right. But I've been ready since right after the fight. I told you guys, we're going to fight in June. I told you, I've been waiting for Floyd and Leonard to let me know when the date is. I've been on Leonard every day for the whole summer. Like, come on. It's been 6-7 months. I want to fight. You know what I'm saying? But whatever's the case, if he was greedy about money, whatever that network, whatever happened, whoever's father is, we got the fight done right now. You know, I'm ready. And I don't care about a whole fight if he went 12 rounds with this guy and this guy. Me and Stav may fight. It's me and him got to fight. So whatever happened in the past, it don't matter. Now, I lost the journey.
Life and death with Perry Brand. Life and death. I knocked him out in 3 rounds. Stars make fights, as he says.
Yep. And if you saw what I did to Porky as well. So that don't mean nothing right now. It's me and you, baby.
All right, guys. You got me excited for the fight next week. Thank you very much for your time. I'll see you next week.
Our next question is going to come from Garrett Davies from the London Telegraph. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, gentlemen. Happy New Year, James, Badou, Lou, and Leonard. Thank you for having us today. Couple of questions for Badou, first of all. Badou, talk to us about the abilities that you see in James Degale, and how do you actually beat him?
He's athletic. He's a good mover. He's a good fighter. Come fight night, you'll see how I beat him.
But if you could just elaborate slightly on how you beat him technically.
No, I'm not going to give away my game plan, but you'll find out. You know, go live on Sky Sports or Showtime, or come live at the Barclays Center. You'll find out.
Let me put it this way, then. Do you think James is going to be one of the trickiest opponents you've ever faced?
I don't know. We have to wait till fight night and see. Styles make fights. You never know. Anything can happen in the square circle.
Thank you. And James, Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year, Gareth.
Good, thank you. Who have you faced before, James, who is similar to Badou Jack, who you can compare to?
Oh, listen, as I say, listen, I've boxed a lot of people at Badou Jack. Listen, Badou Jack's... he's pretty basic, but he's good at everything. Do you know what I'm saying? But he's a basic fighter, really. But he's good at everything he does. Do you know what I'm saying? So he ain't got no special effects. Nothing's fancy. Everything's just straightforward, but very, very good. He does it very, very well. And in the ring, I can imagine it to be very hard when I'm standing in front of him, because he's very technical. He's got a good jab. Do you know what I'm saying? Works the body well. He's got a good defense. But I've got everything covered, Gareth, man. You know me. And as I say, we've only got to wait 10 more days now, and it's on.
Do you feel that you just have to be James Degale at his very best to beat Badou Jack?
James Degale at his very best, fully switched on, having no time off. I can't have rounds off against Badou Jack. So I'm saying, fully fit, fully concentrated, beat myself, and it's hard to beat me in general, so Badou Jack ain't going to beat me if I'm 100%.
And if I could just ask one more question of James. Obviously, you've been the world champion now for over a year. What's the biggest change in you over the last year, do you think?
The biggest change in what sense?
Just in you, how you prepare, what you are mentally.
Oh.
You know, have you had a year of great growth, for example? I mean, it's an open-ended question.
Every year I'm growing, so I'm saying, mentally and physically. But I'm growing up. Listen, I turned professional when I was 22 years of age. I'm 30 years of age now. So I've been pro for 8 years. And I say I'm a man now, innit? I'm a man. And, I look at things differently and I see things differently. But the next couple of years, Gareth, are my peak. And this is where I've got to strike with iron's hot and I've got to get in there, got to get the big fights. And that's about it.
Gentlemen, can't wait to see you all next week. Thank you very much.
There you go. Thank you.
Our next question is going to come from David Charlesworth from the Press Association. Please go ahead.
Hi, James. Badou. Happy New Year to you both.
I
just have a question for James. Where would you rank this bout in terms of difficulty?
I think it's up there. I honestly think Badou Jack's a quality fighter. I don't really get the credit he deserves. But like I say, his last couple of fights, he's proven. He beat Groves, Durrell. He drew with Boue, but a lot of people thought he won. So he's been spot on with his performances. So I rate it up there. Listen, when I beat Badou Jack, I am number one in division, and people have to start taking note. That's what I'm saying. British, Olympic, British, European, world, and unified world champ. People are going to have to start taking note. But let me just deal with Badou Jack first, and then we can talk after.
Yeah, I mean, you mentioned there about becoming unified champ. I mean, Britain has quite a few world champions, but I don't think it has any unified world champions. Is the fight, do you think that can catapult you into the big time in terms of, like, the British consciousness and that?
Yeah, you'd think so. I'd say it's a big fight. It's at a big arena in New York. This is what boxing at its best is about. And this is when you see the very best of me as well. As Eddie Hearn said, I'm a buzz fighter. I love the big arenas, the big lights, and the big fights. So it should be good next Saturday.
And you mentioned that, obviously, with you took Porky Medina lightly. Has there been any... I take it you won't be underestimating the threat posed by Badou?
Oh, no. Listen, I've taken this, like, serious. I've took this, like, literally, like, the training I've been doing. Like, just stupid little things from, like, making weight. Like, because I make super middleweight so easy, sometimes I left it, like, the last 10 days where I was, like, a couple pound over yesterday. Like, I'm flying. I'm in fantastic shape. I've brought in a strength and conditioning coach for the past 6 months after my last fight, because something was missing after my last fight. I was fatiguing at the end. I was feeling fit, but I was just feeling a bit weak, and it was because I wasn't doing strength and conditioning. So you lot are going to see a big difference from my power to my strength to everything, and physically. So look at me. You're going to see me at the weigh-in and go, wow, it looks good. You're going to see it.
Lovely. Thanks for your time, James. Just a quick one for Badou. Same question I asked James earlier. Where would you rank this bout in terms of difficulty?
I mean, like I said, in the square circle, anything can happen, so you don't know. But, on paper, absolutely. This is probably my biggest fight, absolutely. He's the Olympic gold medalist, world champion, a proven fighter. So, I mean, yeah, that's why it's the best versus the best, the unification fight, two champions fighting each other. So, absolutely.
Do you take any confidence from your victory over Groves that he, James, suffered his only professional defeat to George Groves?
Nah, like I said, Styles made fights, and, you know, I think that was like 5-6 years ago since they fought, so you can't really compare it. And, you know, that was a close fight. I haven't really seen a fight like that, but a lot of people have said that it could have gone either way. James could have won the fight, but no, not really. It's me and him right now, so whatever happened in the past, it don't matter.
Lovely. Thanks for your time, gentlemen. All the best next week. Thank you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, if you have any questions at this time, please press star 1 on your telephone keypad. Again, if you have any questions at this time, please press star 1 on your telephone keypad. And our next question is going to come from Lem Satterfield from the Premier Boxing Champs. Please go ahead.
Hey, guys. How you doing? Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Okay, so my question for both of you, James, you touched on this when you compared your result against Parabon and his result against Parabon. You guys have had three common opponents, and both of you fought the Durrell brothers. You know, Jack, Dale, you beat Andre really soundly one fight after Andre had beaten Derek Edwards, who knocked out Badou Jack. But then, you know, he drew against Boutte. You beat Boutte. You know, so there's a lot of comparisons. He beat George Groves. You lost to George Groves. Can you both address just the different things that can happen in this fight, considering all those results that you've had? Jack, Badou, can you go first?
All right. First of all, we got four different opponents. So I think Groves, Porky Medina, Parabon, and Boutte. My fight with Boutte wasn't a draw, wasn't really a plus. He was on steroids when we fought. So, I mean, Boutte said it himself that my fight, you know, with him was, I won clearly, more clear than him. But that don't matter, really. So, George Groves, that was a long time ago. When James fought him, I fought him, you know, 2 years ago. Medina, I knocked him out. You could say Medina probably was in better shape when he fought Degale, because he probably had a longer time to prepare because it was a title fight. Parabon, maybe he was in better shape for my fight. You know, that was also a controversial draw. So, you know, that's why it's an interesting fight. That, you know, we got a lot of common opponents, but come find out, it'll be a brand new fight.
Right, so you want me to go through mine? Right, listen, the Boutte fight. When I boxed Boutte, yeah, I absolutely battered him for 6 rounds. Battered him. Well, I battered him for the whole fight, yeah. And then Badou Jack boxed Lucien Boutte. It come out he was on drugs. Do you really think Lucien Boutte wasn't on performance-enhancing drugs when he boxed me? Of course he was. Don't be stupid. Do you see the way he finished the fight? Do you see how strong he was? Listen, any fighter fatigued in a 12-round fight. Do you see how strong he finished it constantly on me? Well, Badou Jack knows, but I absolutely battered Lucien Boutte, right? Who else is there? There's Parabon. He had life and death with Parabon. I knocked him out in 3 rounds. He could say he wasn't in good shape, but it don't matter. I still hit him. I still dropped him. He got knocked out, and he had life and death. George Groves, I was a 9-fight novice. I was immature, I was young, I wasn't experienced, I was terrible, it was all wrong. And it was still a close fight, I should have won that. Badou Jack boxed well in that fight, and once again, that was a close fight with him, like literally very close, could have went either way, but he won. And who's the other one? Oh, and Medina, oh man, that guy, like literally, before I went in, I was like, this guy shouldn't even last 4 rounds of me. But I nearly come unstuck because he was fit and he pushed me. He was strong. He was big. So, yeah, stars make fights. Badou Jack says, next week when we get in there, it's me and him. It's the best fight and the best, and whoever comes out is the champ. That's it. So I'm out.
Lou, are you there?
Yes, I am.
And can you address that? I mean, does that add intrigue to the fight that they've had so many different results against so many different opponents?
You know, I don't want to be like, I don't think it matters much, to be honest with you. I think that right now you got two guys right now at the top of their game, who are at the top of their division. I think they're focused solely on each other. You know, styles make fights, you know, throw in some PEDs and throw in some other extenuating circumstances, throw in guys that may be out of shape in one fight and particularly ready for another. I think it's something that can lead to discussion and make for an article. But I think, you know, when we get to January 14th and you get to that main event, it's just these two men in the ring staring each other in the eyes and, you know, who's the better man? It's mano a mano, and it's, you know, throw it all down and put it all on the line. So honestly, I really personally don't think it matters all that much.
But the fans will look at it and they will rack their brains about the different results and the different scenarios, which adds intrigue to it.
You know, intrigue's never a bad thing, and debate's a good thing. And I'll tell you, you know, it's probably a contributing factor because, you know, right now when you talk to people about this fight, and it's really one of the signs of making the best versus the best, is that there's a real clear split in opinion among experts and opinion among fans, in social media, you know, pundits and social media commentary. You know, people are really split almost right down the middle on this one, on who's going to win this fight. And I think there's a lot of reasons for that, and this is just a contributing factor.
Last question. Badou, you still there? I'm here. This is your first fight as a father, correct?
Nah, my second fight. My daughter was born 2 weeks before the last fight.
But how has that changed your resolve? I mean, I know you're really doting over her, and has that made you more focused? Is that something that, you know, changes you as a fighter?
A little bit, yeah. You know, I got to provide for my daughter now, so it's not just about me and my family, you know, my wife. It's about her. Everything I do is for her. So, yeah, it's extra motivation, you know.
All right, thanks a lot. Good luck in the fight.
Thank you.
Thanks, Lam.
Our next question is going to come from Eddie Golden from No Holds Barred. Please go ahead.
Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. First question for James. James, we discussed the four common opponents you've had with Badou, and it's really hard to pick out anything specific, one advantage, since especially you're going to be fighting him on the 14th. So what, in this fight, do you see are your advantages over Badou Jack?
Oh, there's loads, but I'm going to tell you one that stands out. It's just speed, movement. I'm not going to, I'm not going to tell you what I'm going to do, because he's going to be very shocked what I'm going to do, but speed. I'm so much faster than him. Movement. I move my feet so much better than him. There's two things there that is just going to confuse him. I'm going to make things a whole lot harder for him. So I'm not Usain Bolt. Who else is southpaw? I'm not Usain Bolt. Who else he box? I'm not Darrell. I watched the Darrell fight the other day. Darrell blew up after 6 rounds. He's blown out of his ass. He was bollocks. And if I remember, because Badou Jack was fit and hold himself and hold his shape a lot better. That's why he come through the fight.
And Badou, what do you think your advantages are in this fight?
I'm the smarter fighter, period.
Okay. Could you explain exactly why or how you think you're the smarter fighter?
Yeah, you've got to explain that one.
I believe I'm the more fundamentally sound fighter. I believe I'm the more technical fighter. I take nothing away from Degale, who's a good fighter as well, but I believe in my skills. I believe in myself. I believe I'm the smarter fighter. It's not just about throwing millions of combinations or looking flashy and stuff like that. It's about winning fights. It's about being smart. That's
cool.
What took me in.
Cool.
Okay, and one quick question for Lou. Lou, I'm assuming that at least for this fight, this New York insurance situation has been taken care of. Can you comment on that?
Yeah, we have insurance for this fight. The insurance issue in New York has not been resolved. There needs to be a real investigation into what's going on here, and that we need to confront the fact that there's still no way of doing smaller shows, showbox level shows or Broadway boxing, or, you know, the kind of shows that other promoters in New York do on a regular basis. The local grassroots boxing can't be done under the insurance requirements that exist. But for a fight of the magnitude of this card, we were able to get insurance for the show, and the major fights can go on in New York right now. But obviously, you know, where there once were, you know, scores, you know, literally, you know, in the neighborhood of 100 fights in New York in a year, you're probably now, unless things change, looking at somewhere between, you know, 8 and 10 in total, you know, at all venues. So the issue is still a real one. It hasn't been cleared up, but we're fine for this great card on January 14th. And you'll still see big-time boxing in New York. Yeah, the problem is going to be with the type of boxing that develops fighters, that gives you regularity. And, you know, a lot of boxing series that myself and other promoters are doing in New York are still at a standstill.
Okay, thank you, and good luck to everybody in the fight.
Our next question is going to come from Ryan Elliott from Boxing News TV. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, guys. Thanks for having us. Just a quick question for James. Hope you've had a good new year, James. You mentioned before, if you do come through this fight without making any presumptions, that you'll be looking to come back to the UK in perhaps May. Is there plans in place already for if you do prevail, and can we expect you to be working with Matchroom in the near future?
Listen, I'm just fully focused on Badou Jack. Fully focused. I don't want to worry about what I'm saying. Everything goes to plan. I come through this. I will come back and box in London. Next fight, 100%. But I ain't spoke about it to Eddie. I ain't spoke about it to Al, but I know my next fight will be in London after this fight if I come through.
Yep, right. One more question. This will be your fourth fight in a row away from the UK. Just give you mass exposure over in America. Do you think, in a way, though, you've enhanced your reputation back in the UK by fighting abroad and taking these challenging fights? And will that stand you in good stead when you do eventually come back?
Definitely. I've become a bit more exclusive because I ain't been at home. People can't wait for me to come back home. And obviously with my belts, with what I've done over in America the past year and a half has been really good. I should be proud of myself, but I'm looking forward to coming home and boxing in front of my own people, man. Because the atmosphere is second to none. We've got the best fans in the world, and it's time for me to come back home now.
Okay, thank you, James. Good luck to both of you on fight night.
Yeah.
Our last question is going to come from Dan Raphael from ESPN. Please go ahead.
Thank you very much. Just had a follow-up question for you guys. As you've discussed, the winner of this fight, most everybody is going to look at as number one in the weight class. You'll have unified two of the titles. And I wonder, a lot of times when that situation happens, guys look to move up in weight and to take on bigger challenges. They maybe have done whatever they can do at super middleweight or whatever division they're in. I'm wondering from both of you, you guys, have you thought about the future beyond the fight as far as would you want to move up in weight and look for a new challenger, but do like what some other top champions have done is stay in the weight class and continue to dominate, continue to try to unify the other belts? Where's your head at for that that question? James?
Okay. Yeah, Dan, I'm pretty easy, man. I want the biggest fights, the biggest risks, the biggest money, all the titles. That's what I want. So I come through this, everything goes to plan. I'm willing to fight anyone. Andre Ward. As I said before, I do my weight pretty comfortably. Like, super middleweight's the perfect weight for me. But listen, if everything... I want to be challenged. I want to be in the fights where I'm not underdog for once. That's what I want to be. And, with me and Badou, I think I'm a big favourite, and I don't really like it, if I'm being honest, because this is a genuine 50-50. On paper, it is anyway. But, I'm willing to fight anyone after this fight.
So either at 168 or at 175, whichever is the best.
Easy. If everything's right, if the money's right, if there's titles on the line, if I'm going to get the kudos going into the fight and coming out of the fight, then why not? I'm in boxing for the big fights.
And Badou, yourself, what do you think about that?
I kind of agree with him. Whatever the money is, whatever the big fights are, you know, I'm a pretty big guy for my weight class, so
yeah, we'll see what the future holds. But right now, I'm focusing on him. But, you know, the future is definitely at 75.
Okay. Lou, I have one quick question for you, just to clarify from your earlier statement. Do you have a policy that's actually in place for Saturday's fight next week?
We have insurance. We have insurance for Saturday.
Done deal.
We have insurance for Saturday.
What does it cost?
The kind of insurance policy. It's certainly more of an expense than we anticipated, and it's not what we would like in a perfect world. But we have insurance for Saturday. There's no issue.
So what is the like? I remember when UFC had their event in New York when they opened up their from the first time of being able to do an event there. I believe it cost them around, I forget the exact number, $1,000 a fighter or something along those lines. What's it costing for a boxing event per fighter on the card?
It's more than that.
Can you tell me the number?
I don't want to get into exact numbers at the moment. I can have a more detailed conversation when I have the stuff in front of me, but it's more than that.
Okay. Anyway, okay, thank you very much, guys.
There are no more questions in queue at this present time.
Well, you've heard it. Everyone's heard from both of the main event fighters. I know I'm very excited. Lou's very excited. The fighters are very excited. Floyd's very excited. We're going to have one hell of an event come next Saturday night, and we'd like to thank everyone for joining us on the call today, and we look forward to putting on a great event next week. Thank you, everyone, for joining the call.
I would like to say thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining. You may all disconnect and have a happy new year. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining the Jack versus Degale media conference call. Your host for today is Leonard Ellaby, the CEO of Mayweather Promotions.